stripes and bright stars prove perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
I have the mind of Christ. I walk in confidence as a son of God. Here in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I want you to know that I love every one of you. I love you. Jesus loves you. So let's talk about Trump and how God has put Trump in office.
Here to show our numbers to the new administration so that they understand that they can't mess around with women's rights. Those are rights that have been challenged during this campaign by this administration. And so we want to ensure that they see our real numbers and our diversity, which must be included in the America that has to be made again.
We're here to send a message to the Donald Trump administration on day one that we are not going to sit down while he tries to trample all over our American values and our own Constitution. We're going to stand up, we're going to fight back, and this is the beginning of a movement that needs to carry on for the next 4 years.
What are your thoughts on his acceptance speech yesterday?
I thought it was a terrible speech. It was divisive, it was backwards looking, it was sort of dark. It was not what you want to hear from the President of the United States, who's supposed to come into office and try to unify the country, to bring Americans together.
Is it a sign of things to come?
Absolutely. You know, every step of the way, my Republican colleagues who support Trump say, oh, well, you know, just give him a little time. When he gets into office, he'll rise to the occasion. Well, he's in office now, and he has not risen to the occasion. He's sunk to new lows.
If there's anything you could say to Donald Trump moving forward, what are the key issues that you would bring to his table and ask him to...
There's a very, very long list, from health care to women's rights to keeping our troops safe overseas in the midst of his reckless foreign policy. But if there's one single thing I would say to Donald Trump, it is follow the U.S. Constitution.
Are you hopeful?
No, I'm not hopeful, but I'm hopeful that in 4 years we're going to have a very different story happening here in Washington, D.C.
I did support Donald Trump in his efforts to become the President of the United States of America.
What are your thoughts on his on his rhetoric, his talk, the way he's dealing with the media and the people and so forth. What are your hopes for the next 4 years?
Well, I'm confident that the next 4 years will be very good for urban communities and inner cities. And he understands the importance of real estate and how real estate and property has a huge responsibility in how communities prosper. And for those things, I am excited for.
You think President Trump will reach out to the black community and more so than former President Barack Obama did?
Well, yeah, I think he's going to make it a conscious effort to see the community have an opportunity. So, yes. Who is we, first of all?
Sorry?
You said we banned from the country. Who are we?
Muslims.
Muslims?
Yeah.
I don't think Muslims should be banned from
the country. But you elected someone who thinks that they should
be banned. I didn't elect. 62 million people elected.
Well, the people didn't elect him. Let's just be clear about that. The majority didn't.
No, I'm just saying, you're